Hey dear students, welcome to this class. So already in our last class, we had been regarding about how this nutrition stays present in human beings. I hope you already clearly understood that concept. Okay. So same 5 main nutrition steps are there: ingestion, digestion, absorption, assimilation, and egestion. Yes sir. So these are how these nutrition steps are takes place in human beings. Already we have learned in a last classes. So here I am coming with the last concept of this chapter: nutrition in the ruminants. Nutrition in ruminants. Understand? Okay, let's see. Come. First we have to understand what ruminants means. Okay, ruminants means what, sir? Let's see. Some grass-eating animals can swallow large amount of food at a time. So this to grass-eating animals is the way. Large amount of food at a time. So and later bring back that swallowed food into the mouth. Later they bring back the swallowed food into the mouth. Swallow ಮಾಡ್ತವೆ ನೀವು ಗ್ರೈಂಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ತವೆ ಲಾರ್ಜ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಫುಡ್ ಅನ್ನ ವಾಪಸ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತವೆ ಮೌತಿಗೆ ತಗೊಂಡು ಬರ್ತವೆ. ಸೊ ದೇ ಬ್ರಿಂಗ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ದ ಸಾಲಿಡ್ ಫುಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ ಮೌತ್ ಫಾರ್ ವಾಟ್ಸ್ ಟು ಚೀವ್ ಇಟ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಟು ಚೀವ್ ಇಟ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಚೀವಿಂಗ್ ದ ಕಡ್ ಕಡ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಪಾರ್ಶಿಯಲಿ ಡೈಜೆಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಫುಡ್ partially digested food is called cud. Understand? So they bring back the swallowed food again into the mouth to chew it again. Understand? So this process of chewing the cud means a swallowed food or partially digested food. So they chew that food again. Understand? So that process of chewing the cud again is called rumination. That process is called rumination. Understand? So and such animals are called ruminants. Such animals are called ruminants. Understand? See, some grass eating animals can swallow large amount of food at a time and later bring back it to the mouth, swallowed mouth to mouth, and to chew it again. This process of chewing the cud is called rumination. And such animals are said to be what? Ruminants. Okay, let's see how this nutrition takes place in ruminants. Okay, let us see one by one, step by ways. So best example for ruminants are there cows and buffaloes. So cows and buffaloes are commonly called as ruminants because ruminants have a special part in its body. They have special parts in their body, so that part is said to be rumen. They have a special part, rumen part. Hence, that kind of animals are said to be ruminants. Understand? They can eat a large amount of grass at a time, and they swallow that, and they bring back that swallowed food again into mouth to chew it again. So that process we call as a rumination, and such animals are called ruminants. Let us see how this nutrition takes place in ruminants. So same, it follows the 5 steps: ingestion, digestion, absorption, assimilation, and egestion. Okay. So let's first one, ingestion step is there. What it is? Ingestion. Ingestion means what it is? Intake of food into the mouth. As usual, how ingestion takes place in human beings, same case happens in these animals also. They swallow that grass. Understand? They swallow that grass and they break down that grass into simple pieces with the help of teeth. Understand? So they have very sharp tearing teeth. They have very sharp canine teeth for tearing that grasses, to break down that grasses into simple pieces. So the teeth that helps in the breakdown of that grasses into simple pieces, and the saliva. So that saliva mix up with that breakdown food part and makes into very soft and they swallow into the food pie. And they sense that food into the food pie. The food passes through the esophagus. Same, how this happens in the human beings. Same thing happens in animals also. Esophagus is there. Then this is the esophagus. Eyeball, okay, ruminant animal is there. Okay, here it is called what? Esophagus. The food passes through the stomach through the help of esophagus. Same, the motion of that food particle in the esophagus is called peristalsis movement. Then that food is finally reached to the stomach. Understand? See, second step is the digestion. So the digestion of that grass or food, it takes place in the stomach. The digestion takes place in stomach. Understand? See students, in a ruminant, the stomach has basically four parts. First one is the rumen, second one reticulum, third one mesen, fourth one abomasum. So these are the four main parts of the stomach. Remember, the digestion in the ruminants takes place in stomach, in these four parts. Okay, let's see how this digestion takes place in stomach. See students, so they swallow the food and this food passes through the esophagus and finally they reach the stomach. This stomach has four main parts. So this is what we call as a rumen. Understand? Here rumen is there, rumen. So rumen is the first, it is the first part of stomach, and remember it is the largest part of stomach. Rumen is the largest part of stomach. Here in this rumen part, the partial digestion of food takes place, not complete. The partial means not complete. The not complete digestion takes place. Okay, so the food is get partially. The food get digested partially in this rumen part. This is the largest part of that stomach, which is that rumen. Understand? The rumen is the first largest part of this stomach. Understand? Here the food passes from esophagus to the rumen. Understand? Here in this rumen, partial digestion of food takes place. Understand? Then this partial digestion of food is then enters into the second main part, that is reticulum. This is the reticulum part is there. Second main part, reticulum is there. Understand? Observe this figure. This is the reticulum part. The partial digestion food. That partial digestion food is called curd. What is? Curd is there. Curd. Understand? The partial digestion food is called curd. So this curd is brought back to the mouth. This curd is brought back to the mouth. Understand? And the animals chew it again and they re-swallowed it. They re-swallowed that food. So that re-swallowed food again comes to the omasum. This is the third chamber of a stomach. Understand? Here in this omasum, excess water from that food is absorbed. In this omasum. Then this from this omasum, the food passes through the abomasum. So this is the fourth chamber of stomach. So in this part, complete digestion takes place where abomasum. In this chamber, complete digestion of food takes place. Then digested food, then it passes through the small intestine. As you know, in the small intestine, absorption of food takes place. See, after digestion, next step is the absorption. That is takes place in small intestine. Already you know, this small intestine contains villi. Hair-like projections. These villi. So these villi that increases the surface area for the absorption. Understand? So that absorbed food, it sends to the all body cells by the blood. Understand? So when this blood that sends the all digested food to the cells, in a cell the food completely get oxidized and it releases energy. That process what we call is assimilation. That is called assimilation. Understand? So then the digested food then it enters into large intestine. Okay, the digestion food is absorbed by the small intestine. The undigested food then enters into large intestine. Here, this large intestine, salt and water quantity is completely absorbed and it forms a feces. And it forms a feces. Understand? So, that feces is excreted through the anus. That is excreted through the anus. So, that process we call it is what? Egestion. That process we call it is a egestion. Understand? See, students, here this life nutrition takes place in this ruminants. Understand? Remember, they can even digest the cellulose. They can even digest the cellulose. Understand? See, students, cellulose, it is also carbohydrate. It is also carbohydrate. Mainly these ruminants, they can even digest the cellulose. Understand? But we can't digest that cellulose because it is very early. It is a one type of carbohydrate. But it can digest it only by these ruminants, not by humans. Either cellulose, it's very complex carbohydrate. It's a very complex carbohydrate. It cannot digest it by humans. It can be digested by only ruminants, that means cows and buffaloes. Because they have special part that is called rumen. Because of presence of this part, these are called ruminants. Because they show the rumination. They can eat a large amount of grass at a time. And they swallow wood. Understand? And they bring back their swallowed food again into the mouth and to reach you. And they re-swallow their food it again. So that process we call it as a rumination. And such animals are called ruminants. Remember, especially same steps are followed in this case. But because here the digestion takes place in the stomach of these ruminants, they are made up of four main parts: rumen, reticulum, abomasum, and abomasum. Picture is already done, already clearly explained. So please again once again watch this video and clearly understand this nutrition takes place in ruminants. Okay, dear students. So this is our last concept, that is nutrition in the ruminants. Okay, dear students. So thank you for watching this class. Now your lesson, second lesson, that is nutrition in animals is completed. Nutrition in animals is completed. Try to practice this diagram and the parts of the stomach. So draw this diagram in your HW notebook and write these steps. Clear enough? Okay, dear students. Now this chapter is completed. Try to solve the exercise of this chapter. Okay. So we will meet you again in the next class with the next chapter. Okay. Now I hope you clearly understood this concept, that is nutrition in a ruminants. Clear enough? Okay. Thank you for watching this class.